When a pharmacy sells you a medication, no problem. When some guy on a street corner tries selling you that same medication, not cool. Same product, right? But who's selling it matters. Case in point.
We've been hearing from consumers about mailings they get with logos from their local utility companies.
Kevin Brassler is the executive editor at the nonprofit consumer review and advocacy organization Consumers Checkbook. And those mailings aren't the usual bills or service updates.
There's an offer to sell them insurance to protect against a problem in your sewer or water line.
If you've gotten these things in the mail, here's what you need to know. First things first, what's legit? Yes, property owners are responsible for the sewer and water lines that run between the house and the main city lines. And yes, it costs a lot to replace the whole shebang.
The solution that's being sold to them, really by a private warranty company, is an insurance plan. And it costs as little as $7 a month. In many cases, it's more like 15 a month.
Not bad. And?
We're not seeing a ton of complaints about them denying coverage.
Wait, so they collect relatively low premiums and actually pay out if you have one of these high-cost events. So what's the problem? Few things. Problem one is that they're hyping the risk.
The chances of you having a catastrophic failure, of you having to replace your entire sewer or water line, is far less than 1% a year.
Less than 1%, but that's not what they imply.
Because consumers get these letters under the letterhead and the logos from their local utility companies or their local governments. They think that there's an imminent problem here because why else are they warning me about this?
Problem two, they're hyping the expense.
In one marketing scheme we looked at, they were worrying about costs that might be $20,000 or more.
That's a scary number, but
the average claim that they had to pay was very low. Usually, you know, $600, $500 or less. That's not something you typically would buy an insurance policy to cover.
Look, an unexpected $600 bill hurts, but this is why you need an emergency savings account, so you can self-insure against unexpected whammies. And the last problem's just kind of slimy. Why are public entities hawking insurance?
The way they're uniquely misleading is that they're coming in envelopes and on letterhead, not just from the utilities. In the case of Philadelphia, they had city council people sending out these offers. They're not only endorsing it, they're helping to sell it.
Why? Because they're getting a cut.
Cities are helping to sell these plans in exchange for a cut of the premiums paid in. And typically the cut is 15 to 25%. It's a lot.
And these third-party warranty companies are still making money.
The fact that the cities or the utilities get so much of this money speaks to how overpriced the plans themselves are. If they can afford to pay out that kind of selling commission to a city government, it means that there's that much more fat in the policy in terms of what it's not paying out in claims.
Hey, there may be individual situations that make this a good deal, like a bunch of trees, a harsh climate, or just a really old home. But overall,
they're taking advantage of consumers.
Flushing the confusion around sewer line warranties is at the top of the list.